Welcome to the Christmas edition of the SWN podcast. I am here with two of possibly the worst quiz trivia people ever for a movie quiz, which was suggested by our first guest I'm going to introduce. It is former guest on the SWN podcast, part of the foundation of the future for those that are WrestleZone fans. You should be if you're listening to this podcast. It's Ryan Riley. Welcome to the quiz.
Hi, Billy. Thank you. I am very excited. This will be something.
And his opponent in this match of wits and trivia is current WrestleZone Tag Team Champion, still Tag Team Champions after Christmas Chaos. It's Connor Molloy. Welcome to the quiz.
Everyone, I'm sure this will be the highlight of my career so far. So ineptibility at movie quizzes.
I know this is showing up backwards, but it says my foot was on the ropes because my foot was on the ropes. Just remember that.
Just after three.
No, before three. Before.
VAR.
VAR, yes, get VAR.
So for those that are listening, I will tell them to everyone straight away in the first minute or so that this is going to be an explicit episode. Whether we swear or not is in our matter, which I'm sure we're going to when we go through these questions. There is five rounds that we're doing here. There is a 80s round, 90s round, a 2000s to present day round, Christmas, because it's Christmas, and of course, because it's a wrestling podcast, we can get a wrestling round in as well. All about movies. There is no, some trick questions in there, possibly, but like I say, with people I've got on, they're all trick questions. There'll be bonus points on offer, and we'll go through each answers after each round. Everything that all sound straightforward?
Yes.
Awesome. So people might not know how terrible you are with movies. And what's your favorite film? We'll go with that. What's your favorite film? Ryan, we'll start with you.
Oh, my favorite film is probably Captain America Civil War.
It's a grand choice. And Connor?
Back to the Future.
Oh, okay. Well,
oh, no.
a bit of a curveball in there. I'm glad I've got the Back to the Future ring coming on.
I love that.
Right, let's just start the quiz, because the sooner we do this, the sooner one of you can brag over the other for the rest of the time. So, first round is an 80s round. It's called Quizky Business. Again, reference that will go over your head, but it's fine. It's people that are listening, they'll know. Quizky Business is the first round. So question number one. In The Goonies, who did the treasure map actually belong to?
No.
Dick.
The Goonies, of course, is played every Christmas on at least one channel.
This is going to be horrible.
So just to repeat again, in The Goonies, who did the treasure map actually belong to? Question number two. What is the total number of Star Wars films released in the 1980s? The bonus point here, you get two bonus points if you can name them.
I'm not even sure I can name Star Wars film. Back.
I thought the first question was the easiest one in this lot. So this is not going to go well.
You get a bonus point per correct one.
Yeah. All right. So there's 2 points in total bonus on it. So there's a total of 3 points you can get for that particular question. So what is the total number of Star Wars films released in the 1980s? And for two bonus points, name them.
Wait, doesn't that mean there's two?
Shit.
Yes, we'll get a point.
No.
Okay. All right.
Well, you've got at least 1 point. Fuck.
I would just like to clarify that I have in fact wrote two before that came out. So
right. I'm so annoyed with myself. It's only question two. Right. Question three then. Name the highest grossing film in the 80s.
They had films back then.
They came out on VHS.
In the 80s.
So name the highest grossing film in the 80s. Question number four. What film is a fantasy comedy directed by Tim Burton, starring Michael Keaton and Alec Baldwin? What film is a fantasy comedy directed by Tim Burton, starring Michael Keaton and Alec Baldwin? We're all good. All good with that one. Well, we'll move on. Question number five. What's the name of Short Circuit's robotic hero?
Oh,
don't know about them words.
Oh, what is it? My brother's going to hate me because this is one of my older brother's favourite films.
So question five, what's the name of Short Circuit's robotic hero?
No,
I think I might need to move these down to five questions around just for everyone's sanity. But we're question six. In Stand By Me, what were River Phoenix and his friends searching for? Question seven, if you get the next one wrong, I think someone's going to kill you from the WrestleZone roster, just to warn you. In the Stand By Me, what were River Phoenix and his friends searching for? It's question six. Question seven, what was the name of the female protagonist in the movie Terminator?
I'm sorry, Crusher. I'm sorry.
What was the name of the female protagonist in the movie Terminator? Question eight, which I think this might be Connor's other point in this thing. Question eight, in the 1985 film Back to the Future, Doc makes a time machine from which brand of car?
Well, I've got at least two.
In the 1985 film Back to the Future, Doc makes a time machine from which brand of car? Question number nine, in which city does the movie Ghostbusters take place?
I'm sorry, Scott. I'm so sorry. I don't know.
So nine, in which city does the movie Ghostbusters take place? And finally, you'll be glad to know in this round, Nobody Puts Baby in a Corner is a famous line from which 1987 film?
Oh, I'm sweeping up the points now. I think. Stay there.
So Nobody Puts Baby in a Corner is a famous line from which 1987 film?
No, I've never seen it, but just think
like,
I know it.
If it's, well, it is the film that, because I've written it down. It's a good film. It's a good film. Anyone, do you want any questions repeated? Are you all good to go through the answers?
I didn't put anything for four and five, but I don't know, even if you read them out again.
All right. Okay. Ryan, you all right?
Yeah, I'm good.
So, question one was, in the Goonies, who did the treasure map actually belong to? What was your answers?
I put the king.
I put Chunk because I was bullied in school and got asked to do the truffle shuffle all the time.
It was One-Eyed Willy was the answer. It's One-Eyed Willy. So I think we know the answer to the first part of this one. What is the total number of Star Wars films released in the 1980s?
Two.
Yep, because I'm an idiot. And name them. So what have you got?
Empire Strikes Back.
Okay.
And Return of the Jedi.
3 points.
Oh yes! I've not even seen them.
How did you do, Connor? Was it just, did you get?
I put Phantom Menace and Empire Strikes.
Well, you got 1 point extra there, so that's two in total.
Well played.
Phantom Menace.
Empire Strikes.
Next three was named the highest grossing film in the 80s. Any guesses?
I put Terminator 2.
Good Terminator.
Yeah.
It was E.T.
Okay.
A very different film.
Yeah.
E.T. Yeah, I was surprised by that one, to be honest. That would have been one I would have struggled with in this quiz. But yeah, E.T. What film is a fantasy comedy directed by Tim Burton, starring Michael Keaton and Alec Baldwin?
No idea.
The only Tim Burton film I know, well, I think I know, is Nightmare Before Christmas.
Oh, it was Beetlejuice.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Never heard of that.
You know what? I was going to have Alec Baldwin in there because I thought maybe someone will say Batman 1989, but no, that's fine. We'll move on. What's the name of the Short Circuit's robotic hero?
Didn't have an answer.
No,
I'm going to be raging when you say it because I know it.
Well, I tried to give you a little bit of a clue because it's question number 5 and it's Johnny 5.
Johnny 5?
Johnny 5 is alive.
It was in the back of my head. It's my older brother's favourite film.
So when we get to the Terminator one and the Ghostbusters one, you might have 3 people hating you after this particular round. It's Stand By Me. What were River Phoenix and his friends searching for? Anyone?
I said happiness.
that's so wholesome, but no.
I'm walking along a train line. Or something.
It was a dead body, but it's they did walk along a train line, but no points there.
The only thing I've never seen it. But the only thing I know is they're walking on a train line.
It's a good film. These are all films I'd recommend generally. Maybe not Short Circuit. Sorry, Ryan's brother. What was the name of the female protagonist in the movie Terminator?
Is it Sarah Connor?
There we go.
No! I know Connor. I'm there! Oh no!
This I would is like why to you're... hope you know it, to be honest, to spend that much time with Crusher.
Yeah, this is why you're Crusher's partner.
Question 8. In the 1985 film Back to the Future, Doc makes a time machine from which brand of car?
DeLorean.
I assume you've got the same.
Yeah.
Excellent. Now we're on a roll now. Which city does the movie Ghostbusters take place?
New York?
Connor got the point.
Oh, I guessed Seattle. Again, I'm sorry, Scott.
Question 10. Nobody puts baby in a corner is a famous line from which 1987 film?
Dirty Dancing.
Dirty Dancing.
There we go. Okay. Not as bad as we thought. So after that round, Ryan has 4 points.
Hey, I've got 5.
12.
I've got 5.
Sorry, you do have 5. I apologise. I noticed the other one there. My maths isn't great. So 2, 3, 4, 5. I've got 6 for Connor. So that's quite close. Quite close first round. That's not bad.
Okay.
Take that. The next round is called Ace Quiz Tura. It's a 90s round.
Okay.
We were born.
Don't make me feel older in this. I will dock points. I win. So we've got that. Question number 1, Ace Quiz Tura, 90s quiz. Who played Obi-Wan Kenobi in Star Wars The Phantom Menace?
Oh wait, I know it. I think.
I'm starting to question if that came out. It was 90. It was like 99 or something. Shoot, I guess it was. Always gonna care. It's just me that's gonna be annoyed by it. Question number 2. Oh no, I'll repeat it again for people that are listening. Question number 1, who played Obi-Wan Kenobi in Star Wars The Phantom Menace?
But everyone that's beating us.
You know, I'm surprised that we actually got off the mark. I'm really chuffed that we've got more than 3.
I mean, so. You did give us 1 point.
True, yeah. I did. Yes. Yeah. Question 2, what year was Forrest Gump released?
Oh, I have seen this film. The highest rated IMDb movie that I've seen, which is number 12.
That's an absolute classic. The sweet, the it was the music my wife came down the aisle to. There you go. Fun fact for people.
Right.
So what year was Forrest Gump released? Question 2. We're rolling here. That's fine. We'll be done before you know it. Question 3. What was the first animated feature film to be nominated for a Best Picture Oscar?
Oh, might know this. Might not.
Oh, God.
What was the first animated feature film to... I knew I had a typo in this quiz somewhere. I'm correcting it, even though I'm just reading it now. What was the first animated feature to be nominated for a Best Picture Oscar? Go. Question 4. Who played Mrs. Doubtfire in the film Mrs. Doubtfire? Another film that gets played quite a lot around about this time of year.
So was that question 4, sorry?
That was question 4. Have you missed one? Or
No.
Cool. So I'll repeat that. In question 4, who played Mrs. Doubtfire in the film Mrs. Doubtfire? Question 5. Who played Private Ryan in Saving Private Ryan?
What's his name? Oh, God, I know this one.
Once again, who played Private Ryan in Saving Private Ryan? Will Ryan need saved in this particular quiz at this point?
Probably.
You need Christmas chaos. Sorry.
The poop is on the rope.
Question 6. In 1996 box office hit Matilda, I've again mistyped that one. The 1996 box office hit Matilda was based on a book by which author? There was some literature questions as well. There you go. So question 6. The 1996 box office hit Matilda was based on a book by which author?
Why was that a bit of J.K. Rowling? I know it's not that.
Harry Potter and the Matilda.
I've wrote something. It's definitely not how you spell
it. Question 7. I think this is going to be a straightforward one. Question 7. What sort of animal was Stuart in 1999's Stuart Little?
Okay. I watched that a lot as a kid, actually.
If you get it wrong, then I think something's definitely gone wrong. So question 7, what sort of animal was Stuart in 1999 Stuart Little? Question 8, what is the name of the child who owns the toys in Toy Story?
Oh. He left my mind for a second there, but he's recovered it.
On his boot. Got to remember this one.
Okay, so question 8, what is the name of the child who owns the toys in Toy Story? Question 9. Now, this has got a bonus point attached to it as well. What is the first rule of Fight Club? And for a bonus point, what is the second rule of Fight Club? So it's question 9, what is the first rule of Fight Club? And what is the second rule of Fight Club for a bonus point? And finally, in this round, question 10, who was the skeleton guy in 1993's Nightmare Before Christmas?
Not a Scooby.
The skeleton guy.
All good? Anyone want any repeated?
Number 3 again, please.
Number 3, okay. What was the first animated feature film to be nominated for a Best Picture Oscar?
Okay,
cool. Right. Round 2. Question 1. Who played Obi-Wan Kenobi in Star Wars The Phantom Menace?
So I wrote one down, but then scored it out and wrote something else.
Okay.
So I originally wrote Harrison Ford, but then I scored it out and wrote Mark Hamill.
No.
Connor, do you want to get the answer?
Ewan McGregor.
It is Ewan McGregor.
Fuck!
Oh. Of course, Mark Hamill played Luke Skywalker, and Harrison Ford was Han Solo.
That's it, yeah.
Star Wars.
Yeah, me neither. Because we're cool, Connor.
Question 2. Question 2, what year was Forrest Gump released? Anyone just have a stab at it?
I guess 91.
I put 95.
Oh, 1 year out, 94.
Oh.
If I was doing half points, you might have got one, but no. That'll just complicate my whole grid I've got going on here. Question three. What was the first animated feature film to be nominated for a Best Picture Oscar?
I put Toy Story.
Oh, it'd be a good answer, but it's wrong. Ryan, any advance on that?
No, nothing.
It was Beauty and the Beast.
Okay, I had Casper in my head for some reason, but I didn't write anything down.
I thought Beauty and the Beast was older than that.
So did I. I'm going to double check. I'll fact check. Hang on, Beauty and the Beast. Yeah, because I would have thought Google has been a pain in the... Oh, this is 2017. That would be wrong. 1991.
No.
I didn't...
Yeah. See, I wrote 1991 as the answer to when the Beauty and the Beast really. That's what that was.
Question four. Who played Mrs. Doubtfire in the film Mrs. Doubtfire?
Robin Williams.
Yep, that's right.
Oh, Connor.
Connor's face says no.
Come on, man.
Got it.
You what?
What did you pick?
All
right.
Come on. Even I'm disappointed in you with that one.
Sorry.
Question five. Who played Private Ryan in Saving Private Ryan?
Tom Hanks?
No.
Was it Matt Damon?
It was Matt Damon.
Oh.
That was my wee trick one because I thought both of you would do Tom Hanks.
Was he in it?
That's a terrible bit to clip. Yeah, he's like the main character in it, and they go to find Private Ryan.
I've never seen it. The thing I know about the film is Matt Damon.
I didn't even know that.
1996 box office hit Matilda was based on a book by which author?
Is it Roald Dahl?
It is Roald Dahl.
Okay.
Ryan, you got that as well?
I did.
Excellent. Oh, no, I said you got 11 points. That's definitely wrong. There we go.
I'll take it.
What sort of animal was Stuart in 1999, Stuart Little?
A mouse.
Yeah, I wrote mouse as well.
All right, okay.
Please don't be a rat.
I was looking at your face going, you have put a rat or something. You put something wrong. But that's fine. Yeah, that's fine.
Oh, God. Whew. Nice goal.
What is the name of the child who owns the toys in Toy Story?
Andy.
That's it?
Andy. Connor?
Of course. Excellent. I thought maybe someone might put Bonnie or something like that and just, again, make me feel super old about it. Question nine. So there's a bonus point on offer here. What is the first rule of Fight Club?
Never speak about Fight Club.
What have you got, Connor?
I don't want to break. but don't mention.
Excellent. That's 1 point each. What was the second rule of Fight Club?
That's just don't never talk about it.
2 points. Yeah.
What's that?
First rule of Fight Club is you don't talk about Fight Club. The second rule is you do not talk about Fight Club.
Yes! Come on!
I have not said.
And finally in this round, question 10, who was the skeleton guy in 1993's Nightmare Before Christmas?
No idea.
Jack Skellington.
That's the one.
Come
Pull
on.
Back at the end. Right, so yeah. Do the wee tot up. So Ryan, you were on 5, so now you got 8, 9, 12, according to my amazing counting here. And Connor's on 12 as well. So two rounds in, and it's neck and neck.
Oh, I don't like this.
I know, I did joke about not preparing a tiebreaker, and I may be regretting that now, but we'll be fine. So
you've had your shine. We're working towards the heat now.
Round three is 2000s to present. Because I thought doing 6 rounds might be too much if I was going to do a 10s as well. It's called Casino Royale. Casino Royale for those James Bond fans that get that one. That was the only one I was really happy with. The rest of them were kind of a bit, but as soon as I put Casino Royale, I thought, I'm naming the rest of them after films. Right, so question one. I think this will be a nice easy one for everyone as well, including those at home. They're, I'm sure, watching and listening to this with their notepads out. Question one.
I'm what just was shouting profanities at both of us.
Quite possibly. Question one. What was the name of the first film in the Harry Potter series?
I'm really glad spelling doesn't count in this.
If you give me the American answer, you will get a point docked. Just letting you, making you.
I thought you were going to say bonus point there.
Oh, you know what? You know what? Yeah, why not? If you get the American one, bonus point.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Then I can spell that. I really can't.
I'm just writing that down so I have it for bonus. I'll just put the American one, question mark. That'll do. So that's question number one. Question number two. My favourite trivia fact about any film. For which movie did Tim Burton train 40 squirrels to crack nuts for rather than use CGI?
Yes.
I mean in the actual food nuts. I should really, I don't think I need to clarify it, but I think I should for this medium. For which movie did Tim Burton train 40 squirrels to crack nuts for rather than use CGI?
I guess that I know is wrong, but hey-ho.
And
I feel like Burton film.
Question three. Of which film, of which ship is Jack Sparrow the captain of? Which ship is Jack Sparrow the captain of?
I was going to be better at this one. Films came out when I was...
I thought these would be the ones that you'd get, because it's like when you're all alive at this point. But maybe not. Question four. The movie Scooby-Doo was released in 2002. Rhymes. Who plays Shaggy? For a bonus point, bonus three possible points. Who plays Fred, Daphne, and Velma?
The Shaggy one's annoying me because I know this. I can picture him, but obviously. I feel like I know his first name. Like, what was his last name? I have no idea.
Once again, the movie Scooby-Doo was released in 2002. Who plays Shaggy? And bonus points, who plays Fred, Daphne, and Wilma? Velma. Not in Flintstones. And for those that are wondering, this is non-alcoholic beer. This, my slurring is just natural habit, unfortunately. Question five. What are the five Ds of dodgeball? So there's 5 points you can get. In this.
Do we need to get them in order?
No.
Like,
that would be better so I could read them out, but I don't mind.
I'm just going to guess 5 words. No idea.
So what are the 5 Ds of dodgeball? I'm sure you're going to get the next one. Question six. Which Pixar movie featured a journey to South America in a house held up by floating balloons?
Hope I've got that one right.
Question seven, one of my favourite questions in this whole competition because it's a bit obscure. Which film involves a best-kept village competition being taken all too seriously?
I just watched this. Like, I actually just watched this not long ago, I swear. But at my mate's house.
So, question seven, which film involves a best-kept village competition being taken all too seriously? You'll get this one, Ryan. Next one, I'm sure. Number eight. Which Avengers character was the first to have their own film released in the Marvel Cinematic Universe? I had to word that one carefully because I know there'll be someone out there going, oh, but in timeline order, it's this one. So question eight. Which Avengers character was the first to have their own film released in the Marvel Cinematic Universe?
Oh,
good. Question nine. In Mean Girls, Katie moves to Illinois from which continent?
I actually watched this with my girlfriend not long ago, and I obviously paid a lot of attention because
I've seen this one.
I don't know.
Yes, around here, you've watched this like 4 times.
From which continent?
Yep, in Mean Girls, Katie moves to Illinois from which continent?
Just a guess.
And the final question in this round, which movie was based on Jordan Belfort, the former stockbroker and a convicted felon?
Say that again, sorry?
That's fine. Which movie was based on Jordan Belfort, the former stockbroker and a convicted felon? When he reread at all?
Nah, we're okay.
Yeah, okay. Question one. What was the name of the first film in the Harry Potter series?
Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone.
Connor, you got that as well? Excellent. Yes. What was the American one?
Sorcerer's Stone.
There you go. 2 points each for that one. Question two. For which movie did Tim Burton train 40 squirrels to crack nuts for rather than use CGI?
Nutcracker.
any advance on that?
I can't think of any Tim Burton films at all. And is Edward Scissorhands a film?
It is one of his films, but the answer was Charlie and the Chocolate Factory.
You know what, I'm going to take that as a more Burton.
I just went very direct with Nutcracker.
Ryan, Tim Burton Nutcracker would be very interesting. Probably quite scary. Number three, of which ship is Jack Sparrow the captain of?
Pirates of the Caribbean ship.
Is it called the Black Pearl?
It is the Black Pearl.
Come on, running away with things here.
Question four, for 4 big points. The movie Scooby-Doo was released in 2002. Who plays Shaggy?
All I wrote down was Matthew. I had his first name.
Yeah, Ryan, you got... What'd you get?
I didn't get Shaggy, unfortunately, but I've got one of the other names.
It was Matthew Lillard.
And
I can't give you the point for that. I would like to, but no, unfortunately not.
I didn't get this.
Fred.
Who
got for Fred?
Christmas Chaos.
So who have we got for Fred?
Freddie Prinze Jr.
Have you got this, Connor? Have you got any of the other ones?
No.
Okay. Daphne. No, Sarah Michelle Gellar.
Okay.
And Velma. It was Linda Cardellini. So you got Matthew Lillard, didn't you? No, you didn't. You just got Freddie Prinze. So, 1 point?
Is that correct? Yeah. I only know that because he's in wrestling news as of, at time of filming last week.
He was. Looking to start his own promotion. So, yes. See how that goes. Number five. What are the 5 Ds of dodgeball?
Dodge, duck, dip, dive, dodge.
Correct. 5 points to that man.
Come on.
How many did you get, Connor?
I wrote dodge, deliver, dip, dunk, and doom.
You got 2. It's not bad. 2 points.
Dunk. What are you dunking in dodgeball, mate?
I like deliver.
Deliver, yeah.
Deliver. Question 6. Which Pixar movie featured a journey to South America in a house held up by floating balloons?
Up.
There we go. Everyone's got up.
Went into the cinema to see that film.
We're 6 questions into this round, and Ryan, you've only dropped, well, other than the Scooby-Doo one, 1 point otherwise.
Round. We're well into the end of the heat now, Connor.
Question 7. Which film involves the Best Kept Village competition being taken all too seriously?
Is it Hot Fuzz?
It is Hot Fuzz.
Oh, I've seen this film!
I literally just watched this like a month or so ago with my mates.
Oh, great film. As soon as I saw that question, I was like, that has to be in there because it's so if you don't, if you've never seen Hot Fuzz, it makes no sense. But then when you do hear it is, it's like, of course it is. Question 8. Which Avengers character was the first to have their own film released in the Marvel Cinematic Universe?
It was Iron Man.
So if you did all that and got it wrong, that would have been...
Well, I put Hulk because...
Hulk was right. Second.
No, it wasn't. Hulk came out before Iron Man.
No, it didn't.
It did.
No, it didn't. It came out, I think it came out the same year, but it came out afterwards for anyone that's just, I think Connor's just gone, he's just dropped out. We'll wait for Connor to come back once he's I think he might have just googled when did Incredible Hulk come out, and he'll come back on the screen looking really disappointed because I'm not the person to argue with on this particular subject.
Yeah, you just need to take one look at the Christmas jumper you're wearing.
Exactly. And the fact that the end credit, the post credit of Incredible Hulk was Tony Stark meeting Thunderbolt Ross, you know, so it's clearly before it.
Connor said that with chest and he got...
Well, the thing is, I wrote down Incredible Hulk, then I wrote down Iron Man, then I wrote down Hulk again. I was so sure. Oh, sad.
Connor, that was your hope spot.
I just put me on this one.
We still hear you. We can't see you, so we'll just carry on. We've got in Mean Girls, Katie moves to Illinois from which continent? Anyone want to jump in with the answer?
Sorry.
You're back. That's fine. You've had your huff about Hulk being wrong.
I quit. I wrote... What was the question?
In Mean Girls, Katie moves... to Illinois from which continent?
I wrote Antarctica.
Ryan, what'd you get?
I wrote Europe.
It was Africa. Was the answer? Yeah. Remember the scene in Mean Girls where she like is attacking the girls as a tiger or panther of some description from her African roots. No, okay, we'll move on. And question 10. Which movie was based on Jordan Belfort, the former stockbroker and a convicted felon?
Wolf of Wall Street.
That's right. Go on, what'd you get?
The Wolf of Wall Street.
Excellent. So ended on a high with 1 point each. Right. I'll do my sums again. So 12, 14, 15, 16, 21. 24 for Ryan, according to my calculations. And Connor's got 14, 16, 17. 19. So that dodgeball question was the difference maker so far. As we move into round 4.
Man said deliver.
You know what? In my heart, it'll always be deliver now. That's when I watch dodgeball, it'll be deliver. The Nightmare Before Christmas is our Christmas round we've got now. Round 4. So hopefully for those at home, they may be sitting on a grand total of 41 points. But at this point, Ryan and Connor are not. Again, I'm still very surprised. This is not a bad score for either of you from your reputations on this particular. So we've got Nightmare for Christmas. Question 1. What toy was Arnold Schwarzenegger and Sinbad looking for in Jingle All the Way? For a bonus point, which wrestler appeared in Jingle All the Way? And for those at home who have not seen Jingle All the Way, shame on you.
Yeah, it's a shame on me, unfortunately. I've not seen that one.
For everyone else at home then. What toy was Arnold Schwarzenegger and Sinbad looking for in Jingle All the Way? Bonus point, which wrestler appeared in Jingle All the Way? Question 2. Which household pet does Kevin McAllister accidentally let loose in Home Alone?
Oh. I don't remember this.
Which household pet does... I mean, household is probably...
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, that's...
But which household pet does Kevin McAllister accidentally let loose in Home Alone?
I've seen this film, but I can't remember it, so I've had to guess.
I've got an answer there. If you get like close to it, I will probably might give you a point depending on how I'm feeling at the end. We're not arguing about Hulk in this round, so I'm getting better humor about it. So question three: which actor played the live action Grinch? Ooh. And for a bonus point, name the actor who voiced the Grinch in the 2018 animated film.
What is his name? I know this.
You won't remember.
I know this.
So for those at home, which actor played the live-action Grinch? And as a bonus, name the actor who voiced the Grinch in the 2018 animated film.
I do not remember. As usual.
While Ryan has a breakdown.
I can't remember his name.
Question four. Finish the line from It's a Wonderful Life, which was released before I was born, before anyone gets cocky about it being an old film. finish the line from It's a Wonderful Life. Every time a bell rings, an angel gets it blank.
Okay.
If I misread it, I'll read it properly, because again, anyone gets pissy with me. Finish the line from It's a Wonderful Life. Every time a bell rings, an angel gets his blank.
I've got that Grinch one wrong, which is annoying me.
Remembered his name. He's back.
We'll find out shortly if you did remember his name.
Oh, see if I'm wrong then.
Question five. Bruce Willis plays John McClane, who has terrible luck with Christmas Eve travels, in two different installments of which action series? Again, Bruce Willis plays John McClane, who has terrible luck with Christmas Eve travels, in two different installments of which action series?
Oh, thank God. My brain remembers.
Question six. Who voiced the character of the conductor in the Polar Express?
Oh, I've got two names in my head. I can't say.
Two more names than I've got.
Again, who voiced the character of the conductor in the Polar Express?
It's a weird film.
Yeah, it's a really good one. It's one I end up watching most Christmases.
Really?
Yeah.
I weirded out by it as a kid, and I don't know why.
It's animation, isn't it? The texture's a bit weird.
Yeah.
Question seven. Who plays Buddy the Elf in the film Elf?
Connor, remember his name.
Don't remember it. The answer is Deliver.
Deliver. Deliver plays Buddy the Elf.
Okay. Who plays Buddy the Elf in the film Elf? And I'm realizing I've got two Home Alone questions. Oh well, that's fine. It's a great film. Question eight. In Home Alone, what name do the two robbers give themselves?
Ooh.
And as a bonus, name the two robbers.
I literally just watched, like, last week, watched, like, a thing on Netflix. It was, like, how, like, Home Alone was made. I really should remember their names.
Connor's done some research, I'm finding. He's losing, but he's done some research, by the sounds of it.
I know so, it's not.
In Home Alone, what name do the two robbers give themselves, and what are the names of the two robbers? Question number nine. What 2003 Christmas movie starred Billy Bob Thornton as a department store robber disguised as Santa Claus?
Department store.
That's what 2003 Christmas movie starred Billy Bob Thornton as a department store robber disguised as Santa Claus? And finally, now, I guarantee neither of you will get this. But anyway, what is the name of Martin Short's bad guy character in Santa Claus 3, The Escape Clause? And for a bonus point, who plays Santa Claus?
This is an awful round.
Yes, I know this, but I don't know it.
I'll only add that last question is because Mick Foley, when I met him at Christmas Chaos in 2015, said this was one of his favourite films. So, you know. So you not only disappoint the people listening, but you disappoint Mick Foley when you get this wrong.
He might be listening.
He might be. I'll tag him in it.
He might be listening.
So once again, what is the name of Martin Short's bad guy character in Santa Claus 3, The Escape Clause? And bonus, who plays Santa Claus? So you'd be glad to know that's the end of that round.
Terrible round.
Funny feeling that Connor is... This might be Connor's comeback.
I hate Christmas.
So back to question one then for the answers. What toy was Arnold Schwarzenegger and Sinbad looking for in Jingle All the Way?
I just wrote an army toy.
Fine.
I wrote Action Man.
Oh, it was Turbo Man. Turbo Man they were looking for. And which wrestler appeared in Jingle All the Way?
Hulk Hogan.
Yes, I did write Hulk Hogan as well.
It was the Big Show. He played a giant Santa. So there you go.
Okay.
He beat up Arnold Schwarzenegger. So question number two. Which household pet does Kevin McAllister accidentally let loose in Home Alone?
I put a big spider.
Ryan, how'd you go?
I've seen this film, but I don't want to give up my answer. Because I don't remember movies very well. So I wrote a parrot.
Oh, that famous scene in Home Alone with
Oh, I'm going to get slaughtered.
It was Tarantula, so I'll give the point for Big Spider. I think that's close enough.
Well done, Connor. I bought it. Oh, no. Okay.
Question three. Which actor played the live-action Grinch?
Jim Carrey.
Here we go. Connor, did you get that?
That was Jim Carrey, yes.
Excellent. And name the actor who voiced the Grinch in the 2018 animated film.
No, not a skip.
Benedict Cumberbatch.
Oh.
Doctor Strange himself.
So you both get 1 point for that one. Finish the line from It's a Wonderful Life. Every time a bell rings, an angel gets his...
Wings.
Excellent. That's fine. You know the classics, then.
Yeah. Without seeing them, yeah.
Question five. Bruce Willis plays John McClane, who has terrible luck with Christmas Eve travels, in two different installments of which action series?
Die Hard.
Yeah, Die Hard. Both of you. Excellent. Not a bad round. Not as bad as you possibly thought it was going to be. It's about to get worse. Who voiced the character of the conductor in the Polar Express?
Put Robin Williams.
It was not, Ryan. Oh, no. Tom Hanks. Tom Hanks likes voices 10 characters in that film. It's weird. Good film. Question seven. Who plays Buddy the Elf in the film Elf?
Will Ferrell.
There we go. In Home Alone, what name do the two robbers give themselves?
The Wet Bandits.
That's 1 point. I'm assuming you didn't get that, Connor. Ryan, sorry. And what are the names of the two robbers?
All I wrote down was Hank. Don't know why.
I see where you're going with. It was Harry and Marv.
See, I know these. I'm just under pressure and didn't get them right.
Question nine. What 2003 Christmas movie starred Billy Bob Thornton as a department store robber disguised as Santa Claus?
All I wrote down was Santa Claus.
No, Ryan.
Anyone? All I wrote down was Jack Frost.
Oh, you might kick yourself in the next question. It was Bad Santa. Was the answer to that one. Bad Santa. 10. What is the name of Martin Short's bad guy character in Santa Claus 3, The Escape Clause?
Jack Frost.
It was Jack Frost.
Fuck! no.
For a bonus, who plays Santa Claus?
I can't remember this, but it's
No, it's Tim Allen.
Yeah.
That's a poor round from me.
Oh, man. So we've got 24, 25, 26, 27. 28 for Ryan in total now. It's not bad. Connor got 8. Oh, 26.
Oh,
there's 2 points in it as we go into the last round.
You might need that tiebreaker after all.
I know. I'm thinking of any fact that I can think of. So yeah, after four rounds, there's 2 points in it. This is a lot closer than I thought it was going to be. To be perfectly honest, the fact they're in double figures is incredible as well. As we move into the last round, the wrestling round, because it's a wrestling podcast at the end of the day, which I have not made it wrestling related. I've just called it Harry Potter and the Quizner of Azkaban. Because, again, I didn't know where to put it. And I had my Casino Royale was my 2000s. And I thought I need to put Quizner of Azkaban there. So there it is.
Yeah, best questions.
It's movie related wrestling okay. questions.
Right, got you.
So I apologize in advance. Okay, so question number one. Which pro wrestler appeared in the film starring Jim Carrey, Man on the Moon?
Oh.
So I'm thinking if there's any round that you guys would do well in, I was hoping would be this one.
Just well, honestly,
this is probably the round I'll do worse than.
In lockdown, when we were doing a lot of like quizzes and that online, I came last every single time. Even when people joined in like the third round.
Question one, I'll do that again for people. Which pro wrestler appeared in the film starring Jim Carrey, Man on the Moon? Question two, many wrestlers appeared in Ready to Rumble, an absolute classic. Who was David Arquette's stunt double? Another absolute classic film that everyone should have seen by now, Ready to Rumble.
No.
Nope.
So many wrestlers appeared in Ready to Rumble. Who was David Arquette's stunt double? Question three. Which pro wrestler appeared briefly in Gremlins 2, The New Batch?
I don't know, man.
So, which pro wrestler appeared briefly in Gremlins 2, The New Batch? Come on, you're going to get the next one. Question four. In the 2002 Spider-Man film, which pro wrestler played Bonesaw McGraw?
Easy one.
Everyone else, in 2002 Spider-Man film, which pro wrestler played Bonesaw McGraw? And by the time this has been released, I probably would have melted into a puddle after Spider-Man's come out.
Yep. Likewise.
Oh, I'm buzzing. Day one, 9 o'clock in the morning. I'm watching it. Question five. In Magic Mike, which pro wrestler was part of the male stripper crew?
Can't say I've seen this one.
I sadly have. Magic Mike, which pro wrestler is part of the male stripper crew? Now, next one's for 3 points. That's a big one. Which pro wrestlers have played the main character in the Marine series? So you get a point for each.
I think I know this.
So, which pro wrestlers have played the main character in the Marine series for 3 points? So you'll still get a point for each. So I won't. If you only get one, you'll still get a point for that. Okay. Question seven: which pro wrestler played Ramesses in Nacho Libre? Another amazing film. Of all of them, this is the one I was certain that you wouldn't get. But if you do get it, great. It's a bit of an obscure one. Good film again. Nacho Libre. Which pro wrestler played Ramesses in Nacho Libre? Question 8. In the 1991 Suburban Commando, starring Hulk Hogan, who played Hutch?
Can I guess it wasn't Hutch?
That would be a really great trick question. But it's, I can tell you if, as a clue, no, it's not Hulk Hogan.
Now is it though?
In the 1991 film Suburban Commando, starring Hulk Hogan, who played Hutch? You've got the next one. I'm sure you have. Who played Captain Insano in The Waterboy? Question 9. Who played Captain Insano in The Waterboy? And finally, this final question of this thing we call it quiz. And finally, which pro wrestler appeared as Fezzik in the classic The Princess Bride?
What an awful round. I thought I did bad at the Christmas round, but this.
Oh, come on, Connor, catch up.
So there's 2 points in it. There's 2 points. Ryan 28, Connor on 26 as we enter this last round of answers. Do I need to go onto Google to get a tiebreaker question? We'll soon find out. Which pro wrestler appeared in the film starring Jim Carrey, Man on the Moon?
Jerry Lawler.
Correct. It was Jerry Lawler.
Yes.
Oh, no. He says no. That's fine.
I have no answer for that one.
Pulling it back.
So it's 1 point in it now. Many wrestlers appeared in Ready to Rumble, but who was David Arquette's stunt double?
I just wrote down Courtney Cox.
It was Shane Helms.
Oh.
A previous guest, an Aberdeen Anarchy guest, Shane Helms. So he'll be another one that's disappointed by this. Which pro wrestler appeared briefly in Gremlins 2, The New Batch?
Hulk Hogan.
Yep, it's Hulk Hogan. Did you get that, Ryan?
Oh, yes, he's got up.
No, it is 28 all. Oh, my. I'm actually getting all flustered. Oh, no. Question 4. In the 2002 Spider-Man film, which pro wrestler played Bonesaw McGraw?
Randy Savage.
Macho Man and Randy Savage.
There we go. So we're still all even. As we go into question 5, in Magic Mike, which pro wrestler was part of the male stripper crew?
I did not get this, but I put Batista.
Oh, that would be amazing, but no.
I guessed Dolph Ziggler.
Oh, it was Kevin Nash. Kevin Nash.
I didn't see this. No.
Martin will be fuming. You don't think he's sexy enough to be part of that, do you?
He's not my type.
Question 6, as well, a little thing will pop out for you saying your internet is unstable, so we're going to have to get a winner before my internet dies. You can't leave it at this tie break. Which pro wrestlers have played the main character in the Marine series?
The Miz.
Yep.
And then my other two are guesses. Triple H?
Nope.
Okay.
He was the chaperone. And
that's the one. And the other one was Becky Lynch.
Now, she was in one, but yeah. She wasn't in the Marine. So we've got the Miz, 1 point.
The Miz, John Cena. And then, I can't remember, but was it Ted DiBiase Jr.?
3 points.
No! Yeah! No!
It was John Cena, Ted DiBiase Jr. and the Miz.
Yes!
No! No, I'm 2 points behind.
So 2 points in it now. Again, that's where we started this round.
What an overview.
Which pro wrestler played Ramesses in Nacho Libre?
I put Chavo Guerrero.
I put Silver King.
Oh, Silver King is right.
Surely that gets me 2 points. Come on.
Come on. So come on. 1 point in it now. This is three questions left. In the 1991 film Suburban of Commando, starring... I can't believe we're getting this close to it. In the 1991 film Suburban Commando, starring Hulk Hogan, who played Hutch? Anyone? No? It was The Undertaker.
I wrote down Sting.
It was The Undertaker. It's got a really squeaky voice in it as well. It's quite funny. So I've got two questions left. 1 point in it.
Oh.
Who played Captain Insano in The Waterboy?
I put The Big Show.
Ryan?
I had no answer.
It was The Big Show.
No! He's won it!
So, we've all figured it out by now, but we've still got the last question left. And finally, which pro wrestler appeared as Fezzik in the classic The Princess Bride?
Andre the Giant.
Oh, Connor just stealing it, right? Just absolutely crushing it at the end. Connor crushing it. That's it, Andre the Giant.
Apparently I did.
So I'll just do the final count. Ryan was 31. And Connor was 34. So,
I hope you enjoy your victory, Connor, because you have all the grace and decorum of a reverse
What a sad little life you lead.
What a sad little life, Connor.
After 50 questions of varying degrees of difficulty, I can now officially confirm that Ryan is the worst at movie trivia, and the winner of the quiz is Connor Molloy.
Yay!
Fuming.
I'm actually bit glad that one is one, because I didn't think I would have to actually find in our question. I was like, oh Christ, I might have to at this point.
I'm just saying, right? That quiz defined a wrestling match. When they shine the heat and they come back, and then you won. We had all those false finishes in the last round, and then you got the win.
Just snuck it in, and then just add insult to injury with the final 2 points. That's just, but wow, that was a bit more roller coaster than I thought when we set this up. Thoughts on the quiz? Are you happy with your performance? Oh, Ryan, I'm sure you're not. But how do you find your performances?
I'm disappointed, right, that I lost, but the fact that I got over 30 points out of 50 is. I'm happy with that.
And as the I don't know if we'll do this next year, I'll do another one, but you are the quiz champion for this year, Connor. How does it feel?
My whole life's been leading up to like the biggest accomplishment I've made. I can wrestling there.
So not only did you beat Ryan at the start of the month at Christmas Chaos, you've now defeated him in a movie quiz, which I'm assuming that I will get contacted by the likes of Scotty Swift, Crusher Crabe, and Martin Clunas with their full marks, or at least high marks. But I don't know what else to say. This has been our Christmas special. I hope everyone has enjoyed it. I certainly have. Ryan has not, but Connor has as well. So at least two of us have. Two out of three, bad, as he says, Meatloaf would say. And Merry Christmas to everyone, I guess. This is coming out on Christmas Day. So hope everyone's enjoyed this Christmas episode. This has been the SWN Podcast Christmas Special, Movie Mania. And I'm going to go have a lie down, because that was a bit more exciting than I thought it would be. So, I don't know, do we wave at the end because it's a quiz? Or just go.
Merry Christmas to everyone.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Bye.